The remaking of Democratic presidential nominee Kamala Harris continues at pace, with spin doctors recasting her obvious weaknesses as strengths.
Yes, her nonsensical word salads are an ability to communicate with everyday people, and her hyena-like cackle is the spreading of joy.
All the things that make me mad about those other guys and all the things they do wrong, the one thing that I will not forgive them for is they try to steal the joy from this country. They try and steal the joy. But you know what? You know what? Our next president brings the joy. She emanates the joy.
Joining us now is commentator and journalist Brad Polumbo. Brad, the Dems are asking people to vote for joy. Can you vote for an emotion?
I don't know. Did he just fall out of a coconut tree? Because when I think of the Biden-Harris administration, I think of overseas conflicts. I think of crushing inflation. I think of word salad and cackling and an old man looking lost and confused. And I think of a country where most Americans fundamentally think things are on the wrong track. There's a lot of words for that. But for me, joy just isn't one of them. I mean, it really seems that they've got to push blatantly fake narratives about Kamala Harris because she's not popular. She's never been popular. And they've had to try to shoehorn her in as some sort of popular candidate because Joe Biden just had to go. But I, you know, even the writers at the New York Times ranked her as one of the least electable alternatives to Biden back months ago before she was the nominee. And now they want to pretend that that was never true, but she still has all the same vulnerabilities and weaknesses, and the gaslighting is going to fall flat with the American people. We do have eyes and they still work.
Yeah, exactly. We still understand. Now, look, Brad, I've got to ask you, what on earth is going on at MSNBC? I can't keep up with their on-air lunatics. Have a listen to political analyst Molly Jong-Fass' fascinating description of Kamala Harris.
Yeah, I think it's a really good campaign and people really like her. She's gotten to be a really gifted Obama-level orator. And, you know, she was very much underestimated by the mainstream media.
A really gifted Obama-level orator. Look, Brad, has Molly been burdened by what has been?
We've got another one who just fell out of a coconut tree. I mean, look, this is insane. This is absurd. This requires either a willful ignorance of all of Kamala's many gaffes and weird ramblings and odd laughs, or just a total willingness to be dishonest with the American people. And unfortunately, at this point, I do suspect it is the latter. Kamala is many things. And obviously, like any politician, she has her strengths and her weaknesses. But being a compelling orator like Barack Obama is just not one of them. I mean, she took the be unburdened from what has been literally and decided to be unburdened from reality, from truth, from fact, from what we've all seen. I mean, look, this would be like somebody telling you that Donald Trump, who loves Donald Trump, is like, yeah, he's got the body of a swimsuit model, right? We all have our strengths and our weaknesses. Let's just be honest about them for once. Goodness sake.
Yeah, Brad, I wish you hadn't used that metaphor. You've put an image in our minds now that we really don't want.